You said that President Obama said, of course, there is no military solution, and I think most would agree with that. Nonetheless, in his address to a joint meeting of the U.S. Congress, Ukrainian President Petro Poroshenko did ask for military aid and a special security status for his country. He said that the Ukrainian army needed more military equipment and that the non-lethal aid, such as blankets, night vision goggles, were necessary but insufficient. Now, we know that the aid that he requested has not been granted. Do you agree with the U.S. position on refraining from helping to provide this kind of defensive weaponry to Ukraine?
So the distinction you made is an important one. The U.S. is providing military assistance to Ukraine. It's non-lethal assistance. And that's a position that the Obama administration has held to. And of course, all of us heard President Poroshenko make the call in front of that joint session of Congress last week for lethal assistance. And that was not part of the package that he received when he was in Washington. And the logic behind that is, I think, particularly at a time when you have a ceasefire in place, shaky as it is, do you want to take a step that might be seen as provocative? And let's see if we can move toward a political settlement. I think there's no question in anyone's mind that the Russian army is in a much stronger position than the Ukrainian army. And it certainly would be a tragedy were Russia to have a full-scale invasion across that border into Ukraine. And based on troop deployments that are there and the Russian military presence that we already see in the East, I think the focus at the moment really should be on the ceasefire, keeping that in place, and moving toward a political settlement.
But Karen, do you think that the two are mutually exclusive, even though I'm sure President Poroshenko wants this political settlement to take hold? But certainly if Russia were in the U.S. position, they would feel no compunction in providing weaponry to their allies, you know, just as a show of solidarity, not that the Ukrainians in this case would necessarily be using it in an offensive way. Again, you know, looking at Russia and how Russia sees the world and how it behaves, isn't this sending a signal that the United States and the West is just not going to go the mile for Ukraine in the end?
We have to ask ourselves, what's the long-term strategy here? And a lot of people have said this is a new Cold War between the U.S. and Russia. I don't think it's a new Cold War between the U.S. and Russia, because 25 years have passed since the end of the Cold War and where we are today. And the U.S. and our European allies thought that Russia had made a strategic decision at the end of the Cold War, that cooperating with the West was more in its interest than engaging in open conflict. Turned out we were wrong about that. And that's what the illegal annexation of Crimea shows. It shows through Russian military activities and other activities in the eastern part of Ukraine. But if we don't think there's a military solution to this problem, and if we also make the argument that this is not Ukraine making a choice between Russia and the EU, but rather it's about Ukraine having the democratic right to determine its own future, and for Ukraine not to have a larger country take over part of its sovereign territory, those are the principles that are at play here. And the argument that the Obama administration has made is Ukraine will have, going forward, a deep relationship with Russia, cultural, political, economic. So we need to focus on finding a political solution. And that's what the emphasis has been. And that's why the concern has been that if you provide lethal military assistance, it could be provocative rather than helpful at this point in the conflict.